А где Моня?
Заявление для прессы где будет? Там поставили, где сидушку ставишь?
Я бы тоже ставила.
Без проблем.
Освободите проход по бокам.
First of all, you came to take part in the fifth Interfaith Congress, where political and religious leaders met together to discuss most outlying issues. Also in terms that this is the new building of the United Nations for the country office of UN family here in Astana, and your first steps should bring continued success to our cooperation with the United Nations. Your visit is very symbolic in terms that the government of Palestine has recently donated a new building for the regional presence of the United Nations in Almaty, in our southern capital, and we hope that the day will come when we will come and participate in the same ribbon-cutting ceremony to open the UN hub in Almaty. Your visit is also symbolic because very soon we will sign a new partnership framework program with the United Nations. We saw many avenues for cooperation between the United Nations and Kazakhstan. And finally, your visit is very symbolic because we are on the eve of the 70th General Assembly this September with a huge agenda. Most important challenge facing you and all of us is, of course, the post-2015 agenda. You have had a very substantive exchange of views with President Nazarbayev today on the post-2015 agenda, and of course, you should be rest assured that Kazakhstan will fully support your efforts to promote the ideals and the goals of the post-2015 agenda. Most welcome to you again, and you see how much excited people are in Kazakhstan to welcome you. You know different corners of Kazakhstan, you know different weathers of Kazakhstan. You are the most Kazakhstan weathered official of the world, and we are very much proud that you have acquired such a knowledge of Kazakhstan.
As far as Türkiye'nin muhtarlarının basması şakalarımıza, bizler için, sizler bizden sunusunuzla kavuldanınıza, sizge Alfari adına Kazak Ulttuk Üniversitesi'nin savaş için ülkeye mertliğe ülkeye mertliğe verildi.
Your Excellency, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, let me greet you on this welcoming Kazakh land and provide you and confer upon you the honorary degree of the Doctor of the Kazakhstan State University named Al-Farabi.
Әлемде бейбітшілікпен тұратын оған дәлел соңғы жылдарда Біріккен Ұлттар Ұйымының абыройы мен мәртебесі артуы, академикалық ықпал бағдарламасы әлемнің барлық университеттеріне қолдау тауып Біріккен Ұлттар Ұйымының
around the world universities in different countries and continents provide the services as well and confer degrees among you, and we would like also to share this with you as well.
Біздің Қазақ Ұлттық Университеті үшін осы бағдарламада
it's a great honor and responsibility for us to confer the degree, given your promotion of the peace and stability all around the world.
Осы сәтті пайдалана отырып, сіздің сеніміңізді ақтайтыныңызға сенім.
On the Scientific Council of the University, the honorary degree as well as a certificate of the honorary doctor.
Your Excellency Secretary Time and letting us to be here today with you. It is a great honor for us to convey our sincere gratitude for you. In our turn, we assure you that we shall implement this important mission with pride.
Thank you.
Живей Казахстан, да?
Your Excellency, Foreign Minister Mr. Ilan Idrisov of Kazakhstan, and Dr. Galyam Mutanov, Rector of Al Arabi Kazakh National University. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor and a privilege for me to carry on two important events today. First of all, I was very much privileged to open this new, very excellent United Nations House, which will be our common working place. And I'd like to sincerely thank the government and people of Kazakhstan for their strong support for the United Nations. And I also thank the personal presence of Foreign Minister Idrisov, despite his very busy schedules. I'm sure that with these excellent facilities, the United Nations teams, funds and programs, agencies will be able to work as one team, delivering as one to meet the expectations of the people of not only Kazakhstan, but the people of the world, whom prosperity and well-being and reconciliation. Kazakhstan is known for its championing role as a leading country in this region and also a global leader. The country has been promoting as one of the global leaders nuclear non-proliferation, as well as peace building in a variety of conflicts, and including in Ukraine, Syria, and Afghanistan, and many other places. Kazakhstan is also a strong supporter of the United Nations, including the work of the United Nations Regional Center for Preventive Diplomacy in Central Asia. We have a new executive director, Mr. Dragunov here. I hope you will give him good cooperation and guidance. I participated today's Congress of Leaders of World and Traditional Religions. That was an extension of your country's effort to promote peace and harmony on the world stage. I'd like to highly commend and appreciate the leadership and vision of President Nazarbayev of Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan has helped advance a global conversation between religious and political leaders about promoting tolerance and universal rights, freedom of religion and belief. I strongly believe that religious leaders have a critical role to play. This was also the subject of the United Nations General Assembly high-level meeting, which I convened in late April for the same purpose. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights is clear. Everyone has the right to freedom of thought, conscience, and religion. In Kazakhstan, as anywhere else, all religions and minority groups should be guaranteed this right on an equal footing. Governments around the world should recognize the decisive role of these and other fundamental freedoms in fostering pluralism, understanding, and democracy. Kazakhstan should also continue to make progress on human rights, including the development of a comprehensive national human rights action plan. Close cooperation with the civil society will be important in these efforts. Additionally, ensure benefits all society. And again, I'm very much pleased to reinforce the United Nations commitment and the readiness to work together with the Kazakhstan government and people for world peace and democracy. Just let me say a few words. It's another great privilege and honor for me to be bestowed upon this honorary doctorate degree from the Al-Farabi Kazakh. And I'm very much grateful to be a part of this Kazakh National University alumni of your great university. I know that this is one of the longest serving as well as the largest universities with 20,000 students. And I'm very much greatly honored. I know that by giving me this honor, you are honoring all the men and women of the United Nations who are working tirelessly day and night for world peace and democracy and human rights, even under very difficult and dangerous circumstances. I'm giving this honor to all my staff, and that is why I'm receiving this honor from your university. You are one of the oldest universities in Central Asia, and I will do my best to preserve that kind of honor and legacy of your university. I know that you are celebrating 8 years for the United Nations. This is the 70th, you are 10 years older than the United Nations, and share a similar mission to build bridges of understanding and cooperation and a global citizen. Many centuries ago, your namesake, Al-Farabi, wrote that it is impossible to achieve one's goals in isolation. It can only be done by joining with others. And now I'm joining with your university. I'm joining with the people of Kazakhstan. That is the spirit in which I accept this honor. And let us work together to help people everywhere around the world so that they can achieve their dreams. Dreams that is, everybody should be able to live in peace, harmony, and friendship, and well-being, and dignity. I thank you very much. Romance.